Mitchell, Steve Chavy, Mike Mathis, and Jack Neese. As we get set for game number four.
I look for the Magic to really punch the ball inside to Shaquille O'Neal just about every trip down the floor. They want Shaq to establish his presence inside and get the Pacers into foul trouble. And also, the Magic have to improve their rebounding.
Dale Davis and Shaquille O'Neal on the opening tip, and it's controlled by the Magic. Hardaway played by Jackson. O'Neal getting possession. Banking with Smith's going right to the basket.
And actually, Rick Smith did a decent enough job of pushing Shaq off the block, but he would not be denied. He's going to power no matter what happened.
Jackson. Smith's took a pop down low from Anderson. Now Smith's on the move. Won't count, but a foul call. And it's called on Shaquille O'Neal.
Well, the big people for Indiana have been trying to meet Shaq earlier, push him off the block, as Smith did there. Shaq with a couple of dribbles, and Indiana has the philosophy, let's just play him head up to see what happens before they start coming down to double team.
Jackson for three. Well, Mark Jackson, who had a solid all-around outing on Saturday, although he was not hitting his shot. Dennis Scott for three. So Scott matches Mark Jackson's toss from downtown, and it's a 5-3 Orlando lead.
Actually, Mark Jackson has been shooting better from beyond the arc, 5 for 10 now, than he is regularly from the field.
O'Neal on the rebound. Hardaway racing it down. Hardaway pulls up for three, and he has been on fire from downtown. Did not shoot the three well against the Bulls, but he is now 11 of 17 from three-point range in this series. The Magic with an 8-3 advantage.
Well, both teams are shooting the ball very well from three-point land. You just have to wonder how long it can continue. Neither team has really been cold at all from beyond the line. Penny Hardaway on what amounted to be a slow fast break had Dennis Scott over on the left side. But he appears to me the last couple of games were really offensive conscious, making sure that he's going to get himself involved early in the ball game.
Illegal defense called against Orlando. Smith's with a long-range hook.
And a good job by Nick Anderson blocking out the 6'11" Dale Davis.
O'Neal around Smith's. Once he got the step, Smith's did not want to pick up the foul, so it became an uncontested move for Shaquille O'Neal.
You got to think, Larry Brown sensing right now that the Magic are going to go into Shaq right away to let him make things happen inside. They will probably have to come down and double-team immediately.
Well, Orlando's opened up in the same manner they did here in Game 3. They've hit their first four shots. Bad pass. Hardaway has a three-on-one. Anderson hit by McKee. Yes, and it counts. Nick Anderson finishing off the three-on-one, and he will go to the line.
Reggie Miller out of control here. Lost his footing a little bit. Thought he saw somebody open, but right into the body of Penny Hardaway. And not a good foul here by Derek McKee. He was clearly beaten on that lane. Probably would have been better off just letting Anderson lay it in.
Orlando 13, Indiana 3, and a timeout is taken.
Ahmad Rashad back at Market Square Arena. Now, there were some things written in the Indianapolis paper today about the Pacers saying that the Orlando Magic were a bunch of nice guys. It was hard to get mad against them, guys, like it was when they were playing against the Knicks. So, in effect, these things were put up on the bulletin board trying to fire up the Magic team. I talked to Tree Rollins about that, and I said, Tree, what's up with the stuff on the bulletin board? He said, well, it was an empty bulletin board, so we figured that something should go up on the bulletin board. He said it didn't have any effect on any of the guys, but it was great reading. But I asked Shaq about it. He said, yeah, it affected me. I'm playing mad today. Marv?
All right, Ahmad. Yes, Indiana players pointing out that this series in sharp contrast and going up against a club like the New York Knicks.
Well, that always will be a contrast. Nobody can be quite as mean and testy as New York.
Magic with a 13-3 lead. With 3 minutes gone by in this first quarter, and Shaquille O'Neal adds to that lead. It's a 13-0 run by Orlando. They hit their first six shots. Remember, in game one, the Pacers opened up with a 23-5 advantage, but then lost the game. Orlando came from way back to win. Here's McKee. And the tip is good by
Brown is trying to decide who he wants to go to. That time, Derek McKee. I'm sure he'd like to get it into Rick Smits and possibly pick up a second foul on Shaquille O'Neal. And he can't forget Reggie Miller. But McKee has had a lot of success against Horace Grant.
Scott was well covered by Miller. Could not get off the long-range shot. Miller with a runner. Jackson. Well, Mark Jackson has accounted for five of the Pacers' 7 points. 4 minutes in, it's a 15-7 lead for Orlando. And the Magic just loves the tempo that they have been able to force here in the early moments. This is their style of basketball. And Shaquille O'Neal dominating, but a loose ball foul is called. And that is number two on Shaquille. In game three, he had a sit early after picking up the two fouls.
Well, I'm surprised that the Pacers did not come down sooner and double team. McKee came late after the ball was on the floor, but Shaq is so pumped up for this game to get himself going offensively. He is just attacking the rim, and that's how he picked up that foul, being over-aggressive.
And Brian Hill going with Tre Rollins, a man who committed 5 fouls in 5 minutes the other day, although in game three, Jeff Turner got the call first and did the job offensively. Here's Jackson. And a 3 second violation call.
Well, Shaq misses this first attempt on the jump hook. May have gotten away with a little bit of the shuffling of the feet. And really, I didn't see much of a wave off there. Just a lot of people around Shaquille. I thought he went straight up.
Shaquille sitting down with 6 points on 3 out of 4 from the field. Nice move by Anderson, but he could not put it down. And a loose ball foul against Orlando. It's called on Rollins.
Well, Larry Brown has said he's every bit as concerned about the other post players for Orlando. Nick Anderson, Penny Hardaway, Dennis Scott has been doing some of it as well. He has felt from looking at tape that the Magic have gotten almost more out of posting up their guards.
Magic with a 15-7 lead. 5 minutes in. Another open shot for Jackson. Larry Brown telling us he wants Mark Jackson to take the shots, and Orlando certainly presenting Mark with the open shot.
He will get him plenty of them, and he's right in that shooter's position from the top. That's where Penny Hardaway is going down to double team. They'll let Jackson continue to take it all afternoon.
On the other hand, Larry also saying we are getting so many open shots and have to be selective about it. Scott had a force it with a shot clock running down. Off the save. It will be Orlando ball.
Oh, Reggie scrambling now there, trying to get possession, was in trouble, falling out of bounds, saw the tall presence of Rick Smits and just tried to throw it high, but threw it behind the glass.
The Pacers feel that the wrong people on their ball club are taking many of those open shots.
Also, Dale Davis is going to be left with a lot, as is Antonio Davis, because of the big men of Orlando trying to help out inside defensively.
Miller for three. So Orlando leads by 5, and the Magic have missed their last 5 shots after opening up 6 for 6. Scott for Grant, and able to swing it out. Anderson not able to hit the 3. Here comes McKee in the open floor for Jackson. So the Pacers with a good run to close within 3 points. 9 unanswered for Indiana. Hardaway trying to slice through and was held.
Well, Indiana has been talking about selective fast breaks, being disciplined. This was a fast break opportunity for Reggie Miller pulling up at the 3. They will run all they can with Shaquille O'Neal on the bench. And here's another one as Mark Jackson able to get inside Nick Anderson. All bets are off with Shaq on the bench. They don't want to run when Shaquille is out there because they think he can dominate in a running type situation.
All Horace Grant coming up short. He thought he was fouled. 9-0 run for Indiana, looking for more. Dale Davis dumped it off. Rick Smith. 11 straight points for the Pacers, able to answer the spurt by Orlando. They had a 13-0 run. And a timeout called by the Magic.
I think their game is to outscore you. They want to get you in a quick tempo game, and we have a problem because everybody seems like they got an open look, and sometimes the wrong guys are shooting the ball or trying to make the play. But I would think they would continue to try to get us in a fast tempo game like they had the first half here. And our job is to be selective on who shoots the ball. I want us to run. But if the break's not there, I want us to make sure we post the ball up and put pressure on their interior defense.
Well, Orlando certainly did get Indiana into that fast tempo game right at the start. And they're trying to quicken the pace again. Although Indiana is in the midst of a good run, Orlando has missed its last 8 shots after hitting their first 6. Here's Jeff Turner, who just checked in, and he has had the hot hand. 10 points on Saturday, and coming in for Shaquille O'Neal, and he hits the 3 from the corner to give the Magic an 18-14 lead.
Well, Brian Hill did not like what he saw with Tree Rollins out on the floor. Tree not being an offensive threat, and really getting caught in the up and down game, at least with the smaller team now going up and down the floor a little bit better, and having this perimeter threat trying to draw Rick Smith away from the basket was very effective in game 3 in that second quarter, and Jeff trying to do it again.
And Turner was called for the foul. Jeff Turner said the spinning pinwheels may have helped his game. It hypnotized him into the good shooting performance. He was in the zone. Dale Davis called for steps. So he may be unhappy about the NBA's no pinwheel policy.
Just a case of self-deprecation on the part of Jeff. He has a lot of confidence in his perimeter shot. It's something he works very long and hard hours on.
Here's Scott off the pump. And Orlando able to settle down after that Indiana run. They now lead by 6.
And Larry Brown countering, not necessarily taking this opportunity to give Rick Smith a little bit of a rest while Shaquille is out, and really doesn't like the fact that Rick Smith can't get out and cover a Jeff Turner or a Horace Grant has gone with a small lineup.
Scott will just check in, and it's the pace it out by Turner. It will be Indiana ball. Here's Sam Mitchell coming on. Indiana
Mitchell.
They'll give Dale Davis a rest. So it is Mitchell with Antonio Davis as the two big men and 3 guards on the floor. Miller with Jackson and Scott, and a foul. Dennis Scott. Call for the foul on Byron Scott.
And it's getting smaller and smaller as far as the teams out there concerned. Both coaches making sure they are matched up. Let's see if Byron Scott is behind the 3-point line when he releases the shot. No, he tried to back up. They're just calling it a 2-shot foul.
Byron Scott with 1 most of the penalty for your Pacers.
This has been a first quarter of spurts. 15-3 run by Orlando. 11-0 run by Indiana. Orlando has scored the last 5 points. Byron Scott only 7 of 24 from the field in the Knicks series. In this series, opened up with 18 in game 1, but has dropped off, has not been shooting well. 18 minutes, only 1 of 4 the other day. Orlando Magic, though, with vivid memories of Byron Scott last season. He did hit that big 3-pointer with a couple of seconds left. Gave Indiana a 1-point win.
Byron just 2 for 11 since that 18-point first game. Really struggling with his shot. Not looking very confident at all.
Good play. Scott knocking it away from Anderson. And it will be Indiana ball. Haywood Workman checks in for the first time. So Workman with Scott and Miller in the 3-guard set. Just under 3 minutes to go in this opening quarter. Mitchell on the drive. Sam Mitchell brings the Pacers within 3.
Well, the Pacers that time just spreading the floor as much as possible. Mitchell taking advantage of it as the Magic have had problems defending people off the dribble.
That's a rare miss from downtown for Hardaway. Miller penetrated. That began with a behind-the-back dribble. Reggie Miller appeared to stumble, but was able to regroup and hit on the drive to bring the Pacers within one. Oh, Hardaway may have gotten away with a palm. Here's Scott from deep. Dennis Scott hitting from two-point range. 22-19, Orlando.
George Irvin, the assistant coach for the Pacers, was trying to shout out instructions to his team to take a foul there. They had one to give before the clock hit the two-minute mark, but the Pacers didn't respond.
Again, Mitchell on the drive. This time he was stripped. Kept alive by the Pacers. Scott for three. Rebound, Antonio Davis. Well, Antonio Davis, who took the hard fall on Saturday, as Ahmad reported earlier, hurt his elbows, hurt his back, but is all right with a very impressive bank move on the rebound. Looks like Jack Neese called a technical foul on someone on the Orlando bench. Well, now it's called on Dennis Scott. A technical on Dennis Scott. The personal foul was called on Workman.
Actually, this Hayward Workman was giving a foul there, an intentional one, just because they had a foul to give, and he did it very aggressively. Let's see if Dennis Scott overreacts to that hard foul and maybe tosses the ball right back at Hayward Workman. He did. And that is kind of considered as taunting or possibly starting some kind of an altercation there, as Dennis Scott threw it low, not intentionally trying to hurt Hayward Workman, but he did intentionally throw the ball at him.
Yes, the NBA has made an effort to cut down on those situations because of what it could lead to, and so it is under the jurisdiction of the taunting call. Horace Grant way off. The game tied at 22. A minute 20 left in this first quarter. Wayne Ferrell is on the floor for the first time. He's not seen much time in the series. And that is Ferrell. Indiana leads 24-22.
Well, the offensive end for Indiana looks like the wide open spaces without the big people, Smith and O'Neal, in the game.
Nice move by Hardaway to get it right back, and the game is tied at 24. Ferrell had the step and lost it. Turner with a good play. Here's Hardaway chased by Antonio Davis and draws the foul.
All kinds of driving lanes for Indiana without the big people in there. Jeff Turner just does not have the lateral movement or the foot speed to stay with a player like Dwayne Ferrell. And at the other end, the Magic going to their one of their best post players. Maybe their best, maybe their second best, I don't know. But Anthony Hardaway certainly gets it done in all those post-up situations. If you don't come down and double-team him right away, he is going to make you pay.
Wayne Ferrell has not played since game one of this series. A look at Anthony Hardaway. First couple of rounds, averaged 17 a game. And against Indiana, just under 23 per game, averaging 11 assists. He had 14 and then 15 assists the first two games of this series. The Magic up 26-24, 35 seconds remaining in this first quarter. Has tied the game at 26. Scott with no hesitation for three. Rebound Antonio Davis. And Indiana wants to hold for a final shot of this first quarter. The Indiana Pacers hoping to tie the series at two, with the scene shifting back to Orlando on Wednesday. The Magic trying to go up 3-1. Down to 5 seconds. Down to three. Scott for three. He's been off. Time runs out in this first quarter. Our first quarter that again has seen Shaquille O'Neal forced to the bench early after picking up two fouls, and Shaquille appeared to be on a roll. Magic reel off a 13-0 run. They hit their first six shots. Indiana bounced back. They had 11 unanswered points. Four for its last 15 following the good start. Shaquille O'Neal is back on the floor playing with two fouls. Antonio Davis. Davis had it knocked away by Shaquille. Hardaway putting the move on Scott, and he is held. The basket will not count.
Well, Shaquille O'Neal on that defensive play taking a tremendous chance there as Antonio Davis trying to create something by driving to the basket. Shaq had a couple of strips in game one of this series, but with two personal fouls, he would be better off keeping his arms high in the air so the officials see him possibly not fouling.
Byron Scott called on that last foul. Hardaway on a post-up, a beautiful move by Penny Hardaway. The Magic up 28-26. Hardaway has 9 points. Second quarter, Marv Albert with Matt Dukas and Ahmad Rashad from Market Square Arena in Indianapolis. Antonio Davis with a rare outside opportunity and gets it back. Wayne Farrell giving the room. Shaquille with a back tap, but it's handled by Workman.
Well, there is just not a lot of firepower on the floor for Indiana right now with Rick Schmitz and Reggie Miller and Derek McKee all on the bench. You got to try to figure out where they're going to get some offense.
Well, Antonio Davis going at Shaquille O'Neal, and it's apparent that the intent is to try and get Shaquille suckered in to pick up a foul with Davis going right at him. And a foul is called on Antonio Davis, who did an excellent job against Shaquille in the second half on Saturday.
Well, Shaq had some foul problems there, was not as aggressive here. Shaq having to give ground to let Antonio Davis get excellent position.
I mentioned the job that Antonio Davis did on Shaquille O'Neal with Rick Schmitz in foul trouble. Foul is called. Workman raising his hand, but try to throw the foul with Davis. Antonio picks up his third. I thought, though, Shaq had a lot of good shot opportunities the other day, but was not able to hit.
He did. Actually, Antonio Davis made some good initial contact just to push Shaq maybe one step further out than he'd like to be, but Shaq still got in there, put up some jump hooks. They wouldn't fall, and what was worse for Orlando, they did not have any good offensive rebounds.
Well, Brian Shaw trying to get it to Anthony Hardaway, and Hardaway with the steal. It's a 4-on-1. Hardaway over Mitchell, serving up a faithful. Whoa!
That's the kind of game that Indiana does not want to get into with Shaquille O'Neal on the floor, because he feels that the Magic just had too much firepower. And when Anthony Hardaway can make a play like that, you see the talent that he has and the rest of this Orlando team.
Well, that got a reaction from the Orlando bench at the expense of Sam Mitchell. And you can see how successful Indiana has been here at home during the regular season, right behind Orlando in terms of success at home. Oh, successive rejections by Orlando, but kept alive by the Pacers. Sam Mitchell has provided offense in the first half off the bench to hit 3 out of 3. 6 points. The game is tied at 30. Ryan Shaw now operating against Hayward Workman. The save by Shaquille and pinned by Smith. Shaw facing the double team over Charlie. Shot clock is down to 1. Hardaway unleashing. Just didn't get it off. And the deflection by Shaw providing the Magic with a new 24.
Well, this is the kind of aggressive defense that we saw from the Pacers in the second half of Game 3, out on the perimeter, being very strong with their hands, moving their feet, and really challenging every pass and every dribble, making it difficult for the Magic to get into any kind of offense.
Shaw double-teamed, and then it's kicked out.
There's that defense again, and lack of ball movement is enabling that defense to be very effective. What the Magic have to do is start beating that pressure off the dribble, get into the seams, and make the pass. But Brian Shaw in all kinds of trouble. Grant coming over to try to help out, but just no spacing, too close together.
Sam Mitchell hears it from the crowd, sitting down, replaced by Dale Davis. Pacers and Magic tied at 30. Early in the second, Schmitz. And back comes Hardaway, crowd looking for a foul, and now the foul is called at midcourt. Workman actually breaking up the fast break attempt.
Well, Rick Schmitz had his little hook shot across the lane blocked the last time by Shaq, tried to fake him, but Shaq is being very aggressive with those two fouls. It looks like he's not going to worry about that. He is going to have to be pretty selective, though, because he got away with a strip. He's got a blocked shot, but Shaq just out there playing hard, not worrying about the consequences right now of his foul situation.
And Smith's only 1 of 6 from the field. Reggie Miller and Mark Jackson have returned. Here is Shaquille O'Neal. Well, Shaquille got off very fast. As you mentioned, Matt, looked to be pumped up right at the start, and then was sent to the bench with the two fouls. But he's hit 4 out of 5 for 8 points. Here's Miller. And the rebound lost by Grant.
Well, this is a terrific move by Shaquille O'Neal on the spin. It's going to end up being about a 12-foot jump hook. And even if he makes a lot of those, I don't think the Pacers will mind that much. They don't want to have him get baskets in transition, get baskets off offensive rebound, and get a lot of dunks. They'll live with the turnaround jump shot and the jump hook.
And there is the turnaround jump shot by Rick Smith. Only a second field goal. He has 4. And the game is tied at 32. Last touch.
Decent enough pressure by Reggie Miller, but even better pressure by Mark Jackson, forcing that turnover.
Jackson for Davis. And there are no spinning pinwheels in evidence behind the Orlando Magic basket. The pinwheels have been banned. We did talk about it, though, with a number of Orlando players, and we asked Dennis Scott, has he ever been distracted more so than what we saw here the other day?
I think a lot of guys do see, you know, what's behind the basket, and but back in college playing in Cameron Indoor Stadium, they would hold up panties, bras, they would put up anything to try to get you to miss the shot. I hope I can stay there on NBC, can I?
Matt, Dennis really has to get a grip on himself. Reggie Miller hitting the 3. And the Pacers now lead 35-32. 5 minutes gone by in the second quarter. Shaquille O'Neal right back. And the Pacers lead by 1 point. Dennis Scott referring to his days as a member of the Georgia Tech team that would go into Duke and face a few distractions.
Well, they say that is one of the great arenas in college basketball. A very clever student body that comes up with all kinds of things to distract opponents.
McKee off the fake is fouled. Shaquille O'Neal coming out for the block. Brian Shaw also involved, and Mike Mathis calls it on Shaw.
Well, I think that Brian Shaw thought that they were going to call that on Shaquille O'Neal. But I think he also got hit in the nose on that drive by McKee. And the big concern, as far as the Magic were concerned, whether or not Shaquille O'Neal picked up his third personal foul, but it goes against Shaw.
So Derek McKee, who has been a man who has provided a lift offensively in this series for the Indiana Pacers, with his first point of the day. McKee, 8 of 12 from the field, 22 points in game 3 on Saturday, as opposed to what took place in the series against the Knicks when he was in constant foul difficulty. And the foul on Jackson, that is his first.
Trying to apply that pressure, that puts the Pacers over the limit in the penalty, so they'll be shooting free throws. The Magic have had them in that situation ever since the 8-minute mark, so it would be wise for them to take the ball to the basket, go inside, try to get as many free throw situations as possible.
Well, Steve Javy, in a discussion with Orlando coach Brian Hill, looked to be all under control. I don't think there was any argument involved.
That's an overwhelming edge for the Pacers on the free throw line in game 3. They made 18 more foul shots and attempted 21 more than Orlando, a big factor in that game 3 win by the Pacers.
Brian Shaw has picked up 3 assists here in the first half, hitting 1 of 2 at the line. And and a substitution. Apparently that was the discussion. Brian Hill alerting Steve Jabby that after the free throws, he would substitute Hardaway for Shaw.
On that drive by Derek McKee, I think Brian Shaw was hit in the nose and eye area and has some blood showing, so he had to come out of the ballgame.
Schmitz getting in deep and rejected. That's the third block for Shaquille. Anthony Beaulieu just came on. Rebound O'Neal. And the game is tied at 37.
And that's why Larry Brown does not want to get in an up-and-down game with Shaquille O'Neal on the floor. Shaq can do more damage in that kind of situation and on the offensive court rather than trying to work in the post all the time.
Ran over to help, knocked it away. Miller for three. Yes. Has 12 points. The Pacers lead by three. O'Neal. And Jackson starts back. Jackson pushing it down. Jackson delivers to McKee. Beautiful play by Hardaway. Able to steal it. And here he comes. Hardaway for Anderson. And Hardaway trying to finish it off with an air ball.
Referees Mike Mathis, Steve Jabby talking it over. Jack Neese actually had a walking violation on Shaq before any of this contact. As Shaq, let's watch his feet, just bullying in. I don't know about there, but Shaq could have been called for an offensive foul as he burrowed into Rick Smith. And then worse for Rick, Shaq fell right on his right hip, and that's going to be very sore, I'm sure, before too long.
5:20 to go, first half. Pacers with the ball in a three-point lead. Spence fouled by Grant. O'Neal let him go, did not want to pick up another foul. It's on. No, they changed it. It is Shaquille with his third.
Rick Smith on the pick-and-roll situation, getting the ball out on the left wing, showing the ball ever so slightly, and then driving hard, just trying to draw contact. And once again, Shaq with the big gamble in there, trying to get the strip instead of keeping his hands up high. And Mike Mathis right there on the call.
Jeff Turner will come on. That was not a smart move by Shaquille O'Neal. That's a low percentage play, reaching in to try and slap the ball away.
Well, he's made a few of them since he came back with the two personal fouls. He got away with the strip. He had a good shot block on a hook shot by Smith, which is very difficult. I think Shaq, as I said earlier, just making up his mind. He's not going to worry about that. He doesn't want to get into a thing with the referees. He's going to go out and play his game and play it very hard.
Anderson off the lead. Nick Anderson able to hit over Rick Smith's 41-39, Indiana. So Jeff Turner is back. Turner with Grant, Bowie, Anderson, and Hardaway on the floor for the Magic. McKee being guarded by Turner. Horace Grant guarding Rick Smith's. McKee for three.
Really comfortable with the three-point shots, despite the fact he is 7 for 10 in the series. Oh, my goodness. Penny Hardaway just posting up Reggie Miller, as Nick Anderson did before, and abusing him.
Game is tied at 41. They double up on Smith's. 7 remaining on the 24.
Well, on the previous play, Reggie Miller got caught in front of Nick Anderson. Here he got caught right in between, trying to get around. And Penny Hardaway on the quick catch and move before any help could come.
Indiana maintaining possession. Jackson for three. Well, Mark Jackson has had the touch. He is 4 of 5 from the field. He has 10 points. He's hit 2 from downtown. Indiana by 3. On the turnover, Jackson trying to feed ahead, but a foul is called. And and Jack Meese, and Steve Javy over at the Orlando bench, pointing at Tree Rollins. He did not like what Tree said. That was a warning, apparently. Steve can't be quick on the trigger. You do not want to mess with him. He was right in the face of Tree Rollins.
And you wonder how they can hear in this building.
Oh, they pick it up. As you well know,
they almost have a sensor about them.
Steve keeping things under control. 3.5 remaining in this first half. With the Indiana ball, the 6 on the shot clock.
It's amazing now we're in the middle of game 4 here, and both of these teams continue to shoot high percentages from the 3-point line.
And a foul is called. John Dale Davis is first. Bob Costas and the guys coming up at halftime, and you know, we hate to pull them away from the barbecue. I know they're very busy, having a nice time back at the studio, but they'll have the Prudential halftime report. 3:11 remaining in this first half. Pacers leading 46-41. Horace Grant has been very quiet offensively in this series.
And looking for his first point in this game. And you see the difference there in the scoring. And the big difference is they have, the Magic have put Horace Grant on the baseline when Shaquille is in the game, because they don't, Dale Davis is the guy that the Pacers want to come in down and double team. But if, with Horace Grant on the baseline, Dale Davis can't leave him there. So they're making somebody else double team. But in effect, it has taken Horace out of the offensive flow.
Reggie Miller claiming it was deflected, but that was the right call. It was not. And it is a backcourt violation. Here's another look at it. He lost it.
Good step out by Dennis Scott to force it, but Reggie with a little bit of the acting job, trying to sell it, not real hard, knew he was in the wrong.
Donald Royal has checked in for the first time. Donald Royal not getting the playing time with the emergence of Dennis Scott. Ever since the ankle injury, it has not been the same for Royal. Here's Scott for 3.
Yes.
Dennis Scott with 10 points, and it's a one-point Indiana lead.
Well, Dennis was just 4-for-11 from three land in the last game. That's not good enough for him. He was out before the game. He must have shot 200 shots.
Out of 2:25 remaining, first half. Jackson. And Miller with the good hustle. Mitchell. Rebounded by Royal. Scott was looking for the 3. Played tightly by Mitchell. Anderson back to Scott. Mitchell all over Scott, not allowing the good look. And a foul is called. And we resume with Dennis Scott going to the free throw line. Rare visit for Dennis to the line. And will not have to face the dreaded spinning pinwheels.
He said they never bother him.
Right.
Larry Brown was a little bit mystified at the complaining of the lack of free throw attempts in the last game by Orlando. But he said, how could they go to the line? They've been taking so many three-point shots. They're not going to get fouled out there very often. So far in the series, Orlando on average 19-for-26 from the line. As far as Indiana, 27-for-34. So a difference of 8 on average. Indiana with the big share there.
And Orlando has recaptured the lead. They have hit 8 of 12 from the field in the second quarter. They double up on Spence. Good job on Spence, but gets one in the foul. Well, that's using the 7-foot-4 height advantage. Donald Royal got him from behind.
Well, just a couple of minutes ago, Brian Hill went even smaller by bringing in Donald Royal for Jeff Turner, who had 3 fouls. So Larry now taking the opportunity to get Smits back in there, feeling that he'll be able to guard Donald Royal, who is not real confident from the perimeter right now. However, Donald will have the first step advantage against Rick in a driving situation.
8 points for Smits by virtue of the 3-point play. Pacers 49. The Magic, 47. Shaquille O'Neal sitting down after collecting his 3rd foul. Here's Hardaway, steps over for the block. Came over to help Grant. Rebound Davis. Dale Davis off the boards. Indiana continues. defends in the rebounding department. Here's the double team on Smits. Gives it back, Miller. And rebounded by Dale Davis. Beautiful move by Davis for a second field goal. Indiana leads 51-47.
Now the Magic are very small on the floor right now, but they were getting out-rebounded when they were big.
Shot clock at 6. Scott. Saved by Royal. And it's a 24-second violation.
Dennis Scott looking around saying, where's the foul? He realizes the Pacers are in the penalty. He's just trying to drop that shoulder, put his head down, attack the basket, and see if he can't get back to the free throw line. He just tripped there, either over his own feet or off of Pacers' big foot.
36 seconds remaining in the half. Byron Scott is back, so Scott, Jackson, and Miller, and they go three guards. Mathis over at the official scorer's table. Perhaps they will adjust the time remaining in the half.
It is a two-for-one situation for Indiana here. Trying to get a shot up maybe before the 28-30 second mark, right in that area. Put up a shot, maybe get an offensive rebound. But if they miss or score, that would give the Magic a chance for a possession and maybe one more final possession for Orlando. 38 seconds now.
Yes, so they have a slight adjustment. Byron Scott is in. And back comes Orlando. Down to 20 seconds remaining in the half, and there is a 5-second differential between the 24 and the game clock. Hardaway working the clock down. Shot clock at 5. Horace Grant continues to have his problems offensively. Here's Scott. He was fouled. Foul on Grant, sending Scott to the floor with 4/10 of the second remaining of the half.
Well, the Magic got a good look. Horace Grant got a good look at a jump shot, but a terrific job by Mark Jackson. He had his head up all the way, not only seeing Byron Scott, but seeing the shot clock as well, as Horace Grant able to just prevent Byron Scott from making that layup and send him to the free throw line. But terrific job by Mark Jackson, seeing both clock and man and making the play.
So Byron Scott with 2 shots with 4/10 of the second remaining in the half. Sam Mitchell back, Rick Smits departing. Rick Smits without a foul in this first half. The high point men in the half. Penny Hardaway 13, Reggie Miller with 12. And Indiana leads by 5 points.
Theoretically, you can get a shot up with 4/10 of a second. When it's 3/10, it would have to be a tip. But Larry Brown, I'm sure, cautioning his team is no foul. Put pressure on the inbounds passer.
Of problems at Market Square. They have lost 7 straight here in Indiana. That includes last season's playoff clincher. Look at the leading scores in the first half. Anthony Hardaway with 13, Shaquille O'Neal, Dennis Scott each with 12. And for Indiana, Reggie Miller, the high man, with 12 points. Mark Jackson off to the good start in his 18 minutes, 4 of 6 from the field for 10 points. Indiana in possession. They lead 53-47. Good play on the double team as Grant came over to help. Anderson. Grant changed his mind. It's picked off by McKee, who was fouled from behind by Anderson.
Horace Grant, I think, thinking about things too much. That's where he was getting so many open shots against the Chicago Bulls at the top of the key. He had one. He left his feet and then decided at the last moment to try to pass it as he saw Shaq momentarily open, and then the ball deflected for the turnover. No surprise that the Pacers would go into Rick Smits early. They would love to get number 4 on Shaquille O'Neal.
And they go to Smits, draws the double. Schmitz with the open jump. Oh, he loves that right baseline.
Oh, he just has that feel. Anytime there's penetration, anytime there's a breakdown play, he is the outhead. Just stepping out to that 17-foot area. There's no way that Shaq can get out there if he's protecting the basket.
Nice play on the tie-up. Going back to the second quarter, Indiana with the last 9 points.
The Magic going into Nick Anderson on the first couple of possessions, this time picked up by Mark Jackson, who tying up Nick. Last time he was fronted by Reggie Miller. The Magic, I think, have maybe fallen in a little bit of a false sense of security, the fact that they have made so many three-point shots. They cannot rely on that. They have to get back into this game with defense.
And Dennis Scott able to go glass. He now has 14. Pacers lead by 6. Orlando got off to the good start. They hit their first 6 shots. They were up 15-3. Indiana came roaring back with a good run. Dennis Davis wide open and Rick Spence with assist number 5.
Well, that time a defensive mistake by the Magic with both Dennis Scott and Horace Grant coming to double team. No way should Dennis Scott leave that basket area, because that's where Dale Davis is going to be left wide open.
Jackson very physical with Hardaway. Hardaway got the step. Grant on the steal. Horace Grant took it away from Dale Davis. Shaquille O'Neal with 14. Pacers lead by 6. Schmitz, Davis, and McKee up front. Jackson and Miller in the backcourt. McKee with the room. And last touch by Indiana. Crowd fellow was deflected out by Scott of Orlando. Hardaway and Anderson at the guards. O'Neal, Grant, Scott up front. Is the double team on Shaquille, opening it up for Hardaway. Schmitz with the rebound. Jackson accelerates. Miller for 3. Yes. Mark Jackson made that play, pushing it down court, finding the open Reggie Miller. They double up on Scott. Horace Grant, yes. Horace Grant able to hit. He missed his first 4 shots. 60-53, Indiana. 3 minutes gone by, third quarter. Davis off the head fake, and he lost it.
Horace Grant has been struggling to find some kind of offense here, just coming up to set a quick bump to try and free up Dennis Scott, and in so doing, his man left him wide open for the jump shots, but they have been few and far between for Horace Grant.
Sam Mitchell back on the floor, replacing Dale Davis. Anderson passed on the 3. O'Neal got the step. The Magic looking for a goaltend. Foul is called. They will not get the basket, and that is the first charge to Schmitz.
A little bit of a different offensive look for the Magic, with a triangle formed on the strong side, the same side that the ball is there, but Shaq just working in on Schmitz, and Sam Mitchell did reach up through the rim and knock that ball out. That should have been a good field goal for Orlando. Some of the players on the floor did complain, but not enough to have the officials get together and talk about it. Let's take a look. Watch the basket here and watch Sam Mitchell's right arm going right up through the rim.
Yeah, he knocked it out from underneath. Should have been 2 points for Shaquille O'Neal, who misses on both free throws. Indiana leads by 7, 8.5 remaining in the third quarter. And McKee called for steps. Traveling violation. We saw a host of travel calls on Saturday. Not the case thus far today. Rick Schmitz a moment ago picked up his first foul. Remember, he picks up fouls in clusters. I would think that is a concern of Larry Brown. O'Neal.
Set with Shaq. back getting his fourth, but really this is the way he has to play from the beginning of the game. Get on the offensive glass. Just a little bit of a shove there, actually more than a little bit. He extended that left arm to push Rick Spitz out of there, but Shaq can do more good for the Pacers, not for the Orlando Magic, by getting to the offensive glass.
Horace Grant with the block, his second of the game. Scott met by McKee, who took it away. Recaptured.
A foot race there. Mark Jackson and Penny Hardaway. Penny just too quick.
Indiana with their 12th turnover. Orlando has 9. O'Neal getting down deep and hammered by Mitchell. Sam Mitchell going for the second. Keel just took a long walk. He missed his previous 2 free throws a moment ago, trying to settle himself down. He had turned it around at the foul line in this series. Well, for the season, a 53% shooter against Boston in the opening round, only 58. He improved against Chicago. And now 0-for-4 from the line. You saw the figure against Indiana, and he has been particularly efficient in the fourth quarter where he had had problems in the past.
And no surprise why he would be so squeezing the ball right now, so intense, trying to make something happen. He is not relaxed out on the floor at all.
Derek McKee, coming off the 22-point game on Saturday, has had his problems. 0-for-5 from the field. 5 minutes gone by in the third. Another Orlando turnover. Schmitz fouled by Anderson. Indiana 63 and Orlando 55. Halfway through the third quarter. Schmitz with the jump hook. Gil O'Neal on the floor with 4 personal fouls. Looking for position. Anderson passed on the 3 again. Ran for O'Neal. Good idea. Could not convert. And a foul is called on the Pacers. Collecting his first.
Well, Shaq's going to get double teamed. Give it up very quickly. And then a high lob pass from Horace Grant. And Shaq again trying to do everything so hard. That's normally an easy play for him. But this one going to go off the heel of the rim as Penny Hardaway and Reggie Miller waiting for that rebound.
Traveling violation on Shaquille O'Neal. Recall the quote that Reed passed on at the start of the telecast. Shaquille saying after the game on Saturday, when he comes here, he feels it's like 8 against 5. And a foul. That is number 5. Well, it is Horace Grant. It appeared that it was called on Shaquille, but Horace Grant called for the foul.
And it was on Horace Grant, who reached in and hacked across the arm of Rick Smith. Shaq is playing with 4. One more look at it. Shaq hit him way after Horace Grant committed the initial foul. Probably wouldn't be a bad idea to maybe give Shaq a little bit of a breather right now to let him collect his thoughts. He's thinking too much about his predicament with the fouls, how things aren't going well for him out on the floor. He does have 4. Plenty of time left in this game. And I'm saying just a couple of minutes right now, because he's in danger of picking up that 5th one the way that he's playing.
Indiana by 10. So that matches their biggest lead of the ball game. 5:20 remaining. Third quarter. O'Neal in a step and not able to hit. That's the second jump that he has blown. Reggie Miller extending to a 12-point Indiana lead. The Magic calling for time.
Well, I mentioned earlier, Shaq does not have too many bad days at the office, especially in a row. Here's one missed dunk opportunity. And then one more time, as he had excellent position on Rick Smith. A perfect pass. And normally, Shaq will get a 3-point play opportunity. That one released it just a little bit too soon, and they're really feeling the frustration here, as I'm sure Brian Hill trying to get Shaq's mind in the game and get him refocused on some of the things he has to do, and a number of Shaq's teammates trying to settle him down.
Shaquille remaining on the floor. He's playing with four fouls. Whistle before the shot opportunity. Zion Smith got it from behind. That is only the second call on Smith.
And Rick can't really believe that one. He has gotten away with many more rougher pushes than that one, but he's got to be careful as well.
Indiana leads by 12. Here's Scott. And a Scott taking it right to the hoop. It's been a strong game for Scott. Has not been doing it from three-point land. He's hit two from downtown. 18 points in all. Indiana 67, Orlando 57. 4.5 remaining. Third quarter. Smith's facing the double team. Here's Byron Scott. Put on the line. That's a two-pointer. And his first field goal. Byron Scott missing his first four shots. Oh, Hardaway. Anthony Hardaway with 15. And it brings it back to a 10-point Pacer lead.
Quick double team by the Pacers. Shaq read it all the way and had the cutter, Anthony Hardaway. And there again, that's how Shaq can get his teammates involved and still be a valuable factor out of the floor.
Smith got bottled off. Good play by Grant coming over on the double team, leading to this, a fast break. Scott from Anderson. Orlando, a very explosive team, as Larry Brown and the Pacers are well aware. The big lead is not safe. They opened up with a 15-3 run. Indiana came right back at them, but this is a club that loves to do it with spurts. The Pacers lead by it again. Jackson wide open. This time, could not put it down. Here comes Hardaway. Hardaway on the penetration, going all the way. Anthony Hardaway breaking the magic within six.
A little surprise, Larry Brown not taking a timeout situation here because the Magic on a roll right now, and whatever was said and whatever happened in that last timeout made a difference for the Magic.
3 minutes to go in the third. McKee, who has been quiet. His first field goal. He had missed his first five shots. Pacers lead 71-63. And a Scott working against Byron Scott. Anthony Hardaway guarded by Mark Jackson. Here's Scott for three. Rebound, Grant. Harris, Grant with the fadeaway after gathering in the offensive rebound.
Well, that urgency we said was missing has just come back in the last couple of minutes of play.
Pacers by six. 2:20 left in the third. They double up on McKee. Jackson for Smith. Crowd looking for a foul call. Jack Neese makes the call from the outside. It's on Dennis Scott.
Well, Penny Hardaway on the cut off the double team as Reggie Miller fails to make the defensive rotation and cover the hoop. And now Penny Hardaway using Shaquille again, who ran the middle of the floor right to the front of the rim and occupied Rick Smith defensively, and that cleared that lane for Penny Hardaway and the lay-in on the fast break.
Smith is 4 of 5 at the line. With 14 points. Rick Smith now with 13. Rick Smith with 6 assists, which ties his career playoff high.
Well, Rick is getting double teamed so quickly as the Magic are trying to protect Shaq with those fouls, making sure that they get the ball out of Rick Smith's hands before he does some damage to Shaquille O'Neal.
And Turner back on the floor, replacing Shaquille O'Neal. Hayward Workhouse back for Indiana. Fouls called on Byron Scott. Substitutions continue. Sam Mitchell and Dale Davis return. So apparently Dale Davis is all right. They were working on his shoulder earlier this third quarter. And Derek McKee departs. Only 1 of 6 from the field. 6 points for McKee. And Nick Anderson gets the treatment from the crowd. Anderson is now 2 of 2 at the free throw line. Nick Anderson, the first player drafted by the Magic back in 1989. Put his stamp on this series back in game two last Thursday with that clutch three-pointer with 13 seconds remaining in the fourth.
I want to say, Nick Anderson is not forcing things. He used to get so many offensive opportunities, but the players that he is out on the floor with, he is just waiting his turn and waiting for the opportunities to come to him.
Indiana leads by six. Miller thought he had the step. Workman. Davis is able to keep it alive. And Byron Scott for three. He has been off. Grant on the rebound. Horace Grant has come to life off the boards. His 10th rebound. Minute and a half to go. Third quarter. Dennis Scott looking to back his way. Hardaway picked up on a switch by Dale Davis. And illegal defense called against the Pacers.
Well, the team that the Magic have on the floor right now still has a lot of offensive capability, but couldn't get hurt defensively. Actually gave up a second shot before this defensive rebound by Horace Grant. Running down the floor that trip, Horace looks winded right now, very tired. Things have not gone well for him at the offense of the floor. He's always going to work hard defensively and on the backboard, but he looks like a tired player to me.
That is said the case the other day in game three. Both teams now have one illegal defense. Scott off a nice pass from Turner. Mitchell with the rebound. We come up on 1 minute remaining in the third. Indiana with the ball. They lead by 6 points. McKinney, Hardaway reaching in for the steal, and Hardaway puts it down. Anthony Hardaway with a sensational all-around performance here this afternoon.
Well, he is always ready to step it up no matter what the circumstances, but in particular when Shaquille O'Neal struggles, Anthony Hardaway is always ready to go. The group that Indiana has out on the floor right now, again, tough to find offense, but that'll do it right there.
Nice lead by Workman, pushing it down to McKee, 75-69. Indiana, half minute left. Third quarter, Scott got the step. Scott is fouled by Mitchell. He thought it was all ball, but Mitchell hit with his third.
Tentative possession by the Pacers. Without Rick Smits or Reggie Miller on the floor, Dirk McKee trying to make something happen, but everybody's standing around. That enabled Penny Hardaway to get in there and get the strip and the pass back and the strong finish.
And Hardaway with his fourth steal of the game. Scott, 2 of 2 at the line. 19 for Dennis Scott.
Mark Jackson, lineup.
Jackson is back for Workman. Ryan Shaw coming on, replacing Jeff Turner.
Ryan Shaw into the lineup.
Brian Hill has been forced to go deep into his bench the last couple of games because of the foul difficulties of Shaquille O'Neal. So he's gone to the likes of Turner and Rollins. Seen a bit more of Royal, who we played briefly. Shaw back on the floor. 75-71. Indiana, 20 seconds remaining in the third.
Larry Brown was concerned that he didn't have enough offense out on the floor, coming back with Mark Jackson to make things happen and Reggie Miller.
5 seconds to go. McKee around Grant. As time runs down, Anderson with the block to stop that shot by Derek McKee. 14-6-1 by Orlando, ending the third. Here at Market Square, helping on the pivotal camera, the brilliant running back of the Indianapolis Colts, Marshall Faulk, coming off a terrific rookie season. In fact, Marshall and the Indianapolis Colts will open up down the street at the Hoosier Dome September 3rd against the Cincinnati Bengals. Marshall putting us all in focus, Matt.
Did an excellent job. The Magic have made the most of their fast break opportunities. Only 9 of them in this game, but some of them have been spectacular. And more important for Orlando, they have 20 points on those 9 fast break chances.
And That's foul number four on Antonio Davis. Keon O'Neal out there playing with four fouls. Rick Schmitz on the bench. Larry Brown likes to pace the utilization of Rick Schmitz. Keeps him fresh. Has only two fouls to this point. Ryan Shaw. Anthony Hardaway, Nick Anderson. All with Shaquille O'Neal and Horace Grant. And used by Brian Hill to open up this fourth quarter. Shaw passing on the shot, getting it to O'Neal. And for Shaquille, his first bucket in some time. He has 16 points, and Orlando is with him, too.
Well, in game three, Antonio Davis was able to bump Shaq early, keep him off the block so far in this game, as Horace Grant has a steal.
Alert play by Grant. Hardaway, and he's tied the game at 75.
I was starting to say, so far in this game, Shaquille O'Neal has been able to body and move Antonio Davis wherever he has wanted and has consequently picked up the four fouls on Davis.
18-6 run by Orlando. And the Magic doing it with thievery. Their 10th steal of the game. Four for Hardaway. Shot clock at one. Wolfman had to force it. It's a 24-second violation.
The Pacers have become unglued offensively, very careless with their passing, not moving very well without the ball. Horace Grant having a little trouble dribbling it, but wisely wakes up for Anthony Hardaway, who knows how to finish off the play.
Game tied at 75 with a minute and a half gone by in the fourth. Shaw not looking for the shot. He's been given the ring. That was tipped short, rescued by Shaw, and it's a 24-second violation. That shot did not hit the rim.
That was an outstanding defensive play by Antonio Davis on the in-out, in-again type of play. Into Shaq, back out to Brian Shaw, and then wisely, Antonio Davis got around on the front situation, so they couldn't get the ball back into Shaquille.
Larry Brown getting set to reinsert Derek McKee and Mark Jackson. Miller played very well by Shaw. Miller forcing. Rebound O'Neal. Shaw in the open floor. Anderson for three. Yes. And the Orlando Magic, after trailing by as many as 12, again showing their poise. We saw this throughout the series against the Chicago Bulls, playing on the road, able to come from way back, and they now lead by three. Pacers struggling with mediocrity through most of their NBA existence. Schmitz was blocked. They had never advanced past the first round of the playoffs and turned it around last season, nearly making it to the finals, and certainly in a position right here to advance. Indiana, though, having its problems in the fourth quarter. They are one for their last eight shots. That goes back to late third. The Magic coming from behind and now lead 78-75. O'Neal facing the double team. And Brian Shaw not looking to shoot. And O'Neal fouled. Out on Smith. That is his third. A look at the former ABA teams making it to the conference final last season. Pacers losing in a grueling seven-game series to the Knicks. Prior to that, go back to 85 and the Denver Nuggets, the last ABA team to make it. Traveling. Violation of a couple of hops called on Shaquille.
Shaq a little bit over-anxious there in trying to get the play going, but the Magic offense has picked up ever since their defense got better. And we said going into the ballgame that was going to be a big key. They still have not rebounded well enough. The transition defense not good enough, but there's much better pressure on the ball, and that's why they have 10 steals in this game.
Indiana has gone cold. Shaquille O'Neal has played nearly 9 minutes since picking up his fourth foul. Rick Schmitz is now playing with three, 8.5 to go in the game. Anderson from way downtown. O'Neal battling with Schmitz for the rebound and deflected out by Schmitz. A new 24 presented to the Magic. Shaw Smith's on the block. 3-on-2. Jackson. For Antonio Davis. Another good defensive play by the Magic. And Mike Mathis calling the foul against Orlando. It's on Anderson, his third.
Well, that happened four times in the first half where the Pacers would get scoring opportunities right around the basket and the Magic able to strip, and they're going to get one more right here as Anthony Hardaway able to get his hand in there and knock it loose from Antonio Davis.
Reggie Miller. Once again, Reggie is quiet in the fourth quarter. Antonio Davis.
Has had. He has shown the ball a little bit and then tried to put it on the floor and go by Shaquille O'Neal. This time, Shaq was waiting for him with the arms outstretched, but a good offensive play by Antonio Davis to initiate the contact, and no real complaint by Shaq.
Antonio Davis to the line for the first time. A 67% free throw shooter during the regular season.
And Brian Hill rolling some major dice right here, leaving Shaquille O'Neal with plenty of time, 8 minutes to go, with five personal fouls. And the Magic have some things going pretty well right now, defensively, a little bit offensively, but still a big gamble by Brian Hill.
Anderson! And back come the Pacers, who have hit only one of their last 10 from the field. Smith's from the key. Orlando, 78. Indiana, 77. First points for the Pacers in this fourth quarter. Shaw penetrating. O'Neal and a foul against the Pacers. As Shaquille was able to come up with that loose ball, pushed from behind. Foul on McKee, his third.
Well, Rick Smith, who's passing the ball beautifully today, mainly because he has been double-teamed so much. That time he was into his shot and made a last-moment adjustment.
Matt, you mentioned earlier perhaps the lack of the sense of urgency on the part of Orlando. Both clubs now playing with a sense of desperation in this fourth quarter. Shaw, who was reluctant to shoot earlier, knocks down the three-pointer. The Magic 81, the Pacers 77. Back at Market Square Arena, Marv Albert, Matt Dukas, and Ahmad Rashad with 6:45 remaining in the fourth quarter, and the Magic up 81-77. Orlando ball as we resume, and Brian Shaw, who came up limping, sitting down. So it's Hardaway, Anderson, and Scott, along with Rollins and Grant. Scott with a shot clock running down. A spinning jump shot by Scott from two-point range. Dennis kind of enjoyed that one.
Well, he made something out of nothing. The execution just was not there on the play. Dennis forced it, but got it.
83-77. Orlando, they've outscored Indiana 12-2 here in the fourth quarter. Shot clock at four. Reggie Miller eluding Nick Anderson. Passed up the shot, and it tossed. Won't count. 24-second violation.
Well, Horace Grant did bail out Nick Anderson on that play, who turned his head on the wrong man, Reggie Miller. You don't want to leave him open. It was out of position, Nick was, but Horace Grant saved him by coming out and making Reggie Miller make one more dribble.
Well, Reggie Miller, who has had a number of heroic stretch runs for the most part against the New York Knicks, has not done it in the fourth quarter and in the second half of this series. He did it back in game two, but quiet again here today, only 5 points in the half. Foul on Grant. That is his fourth. Wild pass thrown by Hardaway. Picked up by Jackson. Here's Miller. And hit down from behind. That'll be a two-shot foul. Dennis Scott trying to chase him down. And Miller will head to the line.
Well, the wild pass intended for Tree Long, not loose by Mark Jackson, who just threw it ahead as left. Miller going in clearly for a layup. Inadvertent trip that time by Dennis Scott. Nevertheless, a foul anyway. His right foot, Dennis Scott, catching the left foot of Reggie Miller and sending him sprawling.
Well, Reggie Miller, a 90% free throw shooter during the regular season. One of two from the line here this afternoon. Shaquille O'Neal back on the floor, playing with the five, with 5:14 remaining. Orlando with a three-point lead. Indiana needing the victory to tie the series at two. Orlando hoping to go up 3-1 with game five in Orlando on Wednesday night. O'Neal, and the foul is called as Shaquille O'Neal and Rick Smits got entangled. Foul on Smits.
Orlando going to the strong side triangle to try to negate the double team from the top. Smits getting caught on the top shoulder as Shaquille O'Neal has position, but the crowd here feels that Shaquille O'Neal did dip that right shoulder and ran into Rick Smits, and I agree. Shaq's sixth personal foul.
But it's called on Smits, his fourth, and Shaquille 0-5 at the line. In this series, he had been 10-13 from the line in the fourth quarter. And Shaquille is back to his problems at the line that hit him during the regular season. The Magic with a three-point lead. Smits with a beautiful thing. Orlando 83. Indiana 82. They are on their feet at Market Square Arena. McKee, a patient setup by the Magic, but Scott not able to hit.
And a nice discipline move there by Mark Jackson. It looked like a fast break opportunity. Shaq not back. He decided to pull it back out and run the two-man game with Smits and Miller.
Byron Scott. Jackson controlling the back tap. Whoa, dangerous behind the back pass. Miller for three. Rebounded by Scott. The Pacers had their chances on that sequence.
And Reggie Miller just looks like he has no legs left in the fourth quarter. We have seen him go cold in previous fourth quarters.
Hardaway rejected. Hardaway for three. Fielded by Grant. Horace Grant with a big bucket. And the Magic leading 85-82. The clock showing 3:15 left. Reggie Miller has missed his last three shots. Also been hesitating, has not been looking to take the shot. Jackson does. O'Neal with the rebound. Hardaway breaking. He stumbled and lost the ball. And a foul. Loose ball foul on Scott. And a Scott call for his fourth.
Eddie Hardaway deep in the left corner. Step back to get the three-point attempt off the air ball as Reggie Miller was trying to battle Horace Grant to keep him off the offensive glass, and the air ball confused him. And then Penny Hardaway, who normally has great hands and finished these kinds of play, actually lost his footing first before that ball squirted out of his hands as Derek McKee was a little bit casual getting back on that play but able to secure the ball and then get undercut by Nick Anderson.
McKee, 7-for-7 at the line. He is a dependable free throw shooter, 74% for the season. And very casually hits both. 85-84, Orlando. Just under 3 minutes to go in the fourth. O'Neal out to set the pick. Hardaway with the step. Hardaway on the reverse. force. That was all Penny Hardaway, who now has 23. Orlando leads by three.
And that is a bread and butter fourth quarter play for Orlando. That pick and roll with Shaquille, with Penny going to his left. Normally Shaq will roll on the play. Sometimes Penny will throw the lob up there.
Miller with six on the 24. Goes to the drive.
Well, Reggie had enough legs on that one. He knew he was going to meet some company there to try to challenge that shot. Smartly took it to the other side of the rim.
Orlando with the ball. They lead by 1 point. We're down to 2 minutes to go. Again, not able to hit the stuff, but he was fouled. That's his third missed dunk.
And all I can think of, Marv, is when Shaq misses these, it's either he's trying too hard or taking his eye off the target, and you can see his head turn a little bit to the left as they're hitting the heel of the rim. And of course, the other thing is he anticipates the fact that he is going to be fouled and fouled hard, and maybe he's thinking about it.
Shaquille 0 for 6 at the line. Pinwheel effect.
He'll go for anything at this point to nail one.
Having an embarrassing time at the foul line. Reaching called on Grant. Horace Grant has fouled out. Horace departs with only 7 points, 3 of 8 shooting. He did have 12 rebounds, 3 blocks.
Horace Grant trying to reach in and knock that ball loose from Horace Grant. Didn't reach across and foul. Not a very smooth offensive game for Horace Grant, but always battling defensively, always on the backboards as he helped bring the Magic back to even up the gap that was 6 rebounds in the first half. The Magic closing that as they get back into this game, and they did it with some defense and definitely with some rebounding.
Rick Smits to the line. He's 6 of 7 at the line, a 75% free throw shooter during the regular season. You see 84 for the Suns. He's tied the game at 87.
Horace Grant just thoroughly disappointed. Wanted to be in the ball game down the stretch. And Penny Hardaway saying, "Don't worry about it, Horace. We'll pick it up for you."
Well, that's a major loss, particularly involved in a close contest. Anderson able to get to the loose ball. Pacers and Magic tied at 87. A minute and a half left in regulation. Shaquille O'Neal picks up number 6.
Another play that the Magic like to use with that high screen roll. Not a roll when Jeff Turner's there. He's going to spot up. Catches at the top, has the option to shoot it, or Shaquille will try to dive into the lane and cover up his defender. He just did it with too much effort. Let's watch it as Shaq backing in on Rick Smits, and actually Rick backing off a little bit, taking a little bit of a bump, and possibly catching that left elbow to knock him to the floor.
So the 39-year-old combination player, assistant coach, Tree Rollins, replacing Shaquille O'Neal. Both O'Neal and Grant have fouled out. It has been a nightmare for Shaquille. 16 points, 0 for 8 from the line. And a foul is called. Timeout, rundown. The Magic, 3 left. Pacers with 2, both clubs over the foul limit. Orlando now without Shaquille O'Neal and Horace Grant. They lost both on fouls. The game is tied at 87. A minute 20 to go in this fourth quarter. Shaquille O'Neal missing 3 dunks, 0 for 8 at the foul line. We try to check the record books in terms of worst free throw shooting performances in the history of NBA playoff competition. It's not in there now. But you mentioned Wilt Chamberlain might be in there in some form.
I don't think he had an offer for big numbers, but for some 20 attempts, and now the Magic going, just leaving Tree Rollins in a one-on-one situation for Rick Smith. I'm not all surprised by that, because Brian Hill, I'm sure, worried about Reggie Miller getting a wide-open look. Ball going inside to Smith. No double, even after he puts the ball on the floor. It'll be interesting to see how the Pacers defend Penny Hardaway going the other way. Larry Brown has, on a couple of occasions, put Derek McKee, his best defensive player, on Penny Hardaway. And if he did that, he might put Mark Jackson maybe on Jeff Turner.
Rick Smith getting the front rim, 8 of 10 from the line. And you can see Indiana 7 of 11 at the line here in the fourth quarter. 18 points for Smith. Make it 19 along with 7 assists, which is a career playoff high. Indiana by 2.
With a great look, and he had it halfway down.
Out of 35 seconds, Miller still having his difficulties in the fourth quarter. Indiana with a two-point lead. Orlando calls for time as the Indiana Pacers try to tie this series at 2. Orlando hoping to take a 3-1 lead, but it's Indiana with an 89-87 lead. Brian Shaw, who hobbled off earlier this fourth quarter, is back on Hill inbound. 28-4-10 seconds remaining in the fourth. 20 on the shot clock. They are on their feet at Market Square Arena. Hardaway once again guarded by McKee. Hardaway for Turner. Hardaway checking the clock. Backs it up to go now against Dale Davis. Here's Brian Shaw for three. Brian Shaw, who hit a three-pointer earlier, comes off the bench to knock it down from downtown, and Orlando now leads 90-89 with 13 and 3/10 seconds remaining. A huge shot by that man, Brian Shaw, signed as a free agent by Orlando after 2.5 years with Miami, originally a first-round pick of the Celtics back in 88. The three-pointer giving the Magic a one-point lead. Orlando taking the delay of the game to check out the Indiana alignment. 13 3/10 seconds to go in this fourth quarter, and Derek McKee will throw in.
Pacers have had success going inside to Rick Smith. The last time they did it, the Magic left Tree Rollins alone with him.
Indiana has one timeout left. They had some trouble getting it in. Now to 10 seconds. Jackson, Miller taking the shot.
The situation, but with Shaquille O'Neal fouled out, Horace Grant fouled out, the Magic have to be thinking 3-point shot here. Take their chances, try to get the win now, although they would take a 2 on the follow-up and take their chances in overtime, but I'm not sure. I have a good feeling they'll look for a 3-point shot here. Dennis Scott, Nick Anderson, Penny Hardaway.
One timeout remaining for each club. 2.10 seconds to go. The Pacers, 92. The Magic, 90.
And it looks like Dennis Scott will be the inbound passer, and that is usually the man that will bust wide open with 5 seconds to go in the fourth quarter.
Scott throwing in from near midcourt. Brian Shaw with a three-pointer to give Orlando the lead. Reggie Miller answering with a three to give Indiana the lead. Delay of game taken by Miller. Larry Brown able to check things out. Now telling Miller to drop off Scott. Hardaway. Now three. Here is the three-pointer. Yes! With 1 3/10 convincing finish here at Market Square Arena, Indiana. Now calls for the time, and Coach Dukas right on target.
Everybody, for the three. Everybody on the floor for Orlando capable of knocking a three-point shot down. It was clearly set up. Get the ball into Penny and see what he could create. Good defense, actually, by Haywood Workwich to force Hardaway to his left. And under pressure, Hardaway just put a little extra oomph in getting off the floor to make sure he could get a good look and a follow through on this shot. He pounds both feet into the floor to get up and over Haywood Workwich. Very close to the three-point line, but just far enough behind for Orlando.
What spectacular clutch shooting by both clubs. How rare it is in this type of scenario to see three in a row where it's all on the line.
Well, the whole NBA playoffs, it seems to me, Mark, you know, not every game, but we have seen situations like that in this series. Let's take one more look and watch the right foot of Penny Hardaway and about 3 inches behind that line. But a tremendous job of shooting that shot to his left. I think normally Penny, he likes to make a move to his left normally for the drive, and I think he would prefer to take that jumper going to his right. And Ryan, little body English, getting on that to fall.
26 points for Hardaway, and yes, another memorable Memorial Day contest. Back in 85, the Celtics walloping the Lakers. 91, the Bulls beat the Pistons. Did that game on NBC, and the Pistons very upset, walked off without shaking hands with the Chicago Bulls. And then in 93, the Chicago victory over the Knicks, featuring the 54th performance by Michael Jordan. Well, this one will be remembered for some time. Still 1.3 seconds to go. And the Magic up 93-92. They do not have their delay of game, but they take the timeout. So Brian Hill want to check things over as to how Indiana would play. And now both clubs have used all their timeouts. And we will take another break. Orlando with the 1-point lead. You see 1 3/10 seconds remaining. Both clubs have used all their timeouts. Indiana hanging back in the huddle. The officials trying to get them to make their move back onto the floor. You hear the whistle blowing. Orlando is ready. Larry Brown taking his time and mapping it out.
Already one delay of game warning. It could be another one. I don't think the officials would call in this situation. Normally, you would like to have the ball being challenged on the pass inbounds, but with Reggie Miller, probably the guy that's going to get the catch here. A good idea to take the man guarding the passer and just track Reggie and watch where he goes.
All right, McKee will throw in. It's got to be a catch and shoot. Here it is. Smith with the catch and the shot. Series is tough.